In this video, we're going to go a little farther with equations and talk about modeling with equations. In each of the situations, we want to follow the guidelines that I have listed here. First, we're going to identify the variable. Then we're going to express any unknown quantities in terms of the variable. We're going to set up the model, which might mean a picture or something like that. And then we're going to solve the equation and check our answer. So obviously, at some point in here in the expression and setting up the model, we're going to find an equation to solve in all of these situations. For example 1, we need to find 3 consecutive integers whose sum is 156. So we need to define a variable. I'm going to let x equal the first integer. If x is the first one, they are consecutive, so then the other ones are x plus 1 and x plus 2. So we have defined the variable, we have expressed the unknowns in terms of the variable. Now we're going to set up the model. What information are we given? We're given that the sum is 156. So I know that x plus 1 plus x plus 2 is equal to 156. Now I can solve the equation and check my answer. So altogether I have 3 x's plus 3 is 156. So that means 3x is 153, so x is 51. So if I take a look at that, we can check again. Did we answer the question, find 3 consecutive integers? Well, no, I've told you x is 51, so I guess technically we need to go 51, 52, 53 is the answer to this question. And then we need to check, is there some 156? So 156, it is. So we have answered the question, we've checked and made sure it's correct, so we're done now. Example 2, a car rental company charges $20 per day and 30 cents per mile for renting a car. Janice rents a car for 3 days and her bill comes to $72. How many miles did she drive? Usually when we're thinking about defining the variable, we want to answer the question, how many miles? So we're going to let x equal the number of miles. Now I don't see any other unknowns. The only unknown is the number of miles. So now we're ready to set up our model. $20 per day, she rents it for 3 days. So we have 20 times 3 as part of our cost, plus 30 cents a mile. Be careful. $20, so 30 cents needs to be represented as 0.30 times the number of miles. Our total is 72. So we've set up our model. Now we need to solve. So this is 60. So we subtract 60 from both sides and we have 12. So x is 12 divided by 0.30. You're not allowed a calculator when you're doing these, so I want you to think about how to do this without a calculator. So if I take 12, this is 12 divided by 3 over 10. Dividing by a fraction is the same as multiplying by its reciprocal, so it's times 10 over 3. Then I can divide that in 4 times, and 4 times 10 is 40. So she drove 40 miles. So I didn't need a calculator, even though it looked a little complicated. She drove 40 miles. You can stop and you can check your answer just to make sure, and then we've answered the question. Example 3. If Ben invests $4,000 at 4% interest per year, how much additional money must he invest at 5.5% annual interest to ensure that the interest he receives each year is 4.5% of the total amount invested? Sounds a little complicated, but let's just start with, what's the question? How much additional money? So my variable answers that. It's the amount of additional money invested. Now let's talk about what we have. I have 4,000 invested at 4%. So my overall interest is going to be 4,000 times 0.04, because it's just a simple interest rate. I'm just talking about the interest here. I don't need to do 1.04 if I don't want to, because I'm just talking about the interest. So that's the interest on that amount. The additional money, x, is at 5.5%. for a total. Well, how much total? That's 4,000 plus x times 4.5%. Now, this is one you're probably going to need your calculator for, and that's okay. Sometimes we're going to need our calculator. So let's take 4,000 times 0.04. We get $160 from that, plus x times 0.055. And here we have 4,000 times 0.045, so that is 180, plus x times 0.045. So I'm going to subtract 160 from both sides, so I get $20 over here. And then I'm going to subtract 0.045x, so I'm left with 0.01x. Well, maybe I don't need my calculator after all. So this is 20 divided by 0.01. 0.01 is 1/100. So this is taking 20 and multiplying by 100, so adding two zeros. So I have to invest an additional $2,000, or Ben has to invest an additional $2,000 to make his interest rate overall 4.5% on the total amount invested. The rectangular garden is 25 feet wide. I've drawn a rectangle here and labeled this as the width as 25 feet. If its area is 1,125 square feet, what is the length of the garden? So I have defined x as the length of the garden. You don't have to say let x equal the length of the garden. If you've drawn me a picture, I know what x means. I can see it. So this is a situation involving pictures. They're kind of my favorite because it makes sense. You can have this tangible picture to look at. All right, now what information do they give me? Let's put it in terms of the variable. The area. So the area is going to be the length times the width. So x times 25 is 1,125 square feet. Well, there we go. Now we have our situation modeled. There wasn't any other unknowns to do. So I'm going to take 1,125 and divide by 25. And I get x equals 45. Don't forget your units. This one's in feet. Units are important to me, and I will take off points for not having units on there. Does it make sense? Well, in the realm of 25 feet, to have a length of 45 feet, that makes sense. If I'd come up with like 1,000, then I would say, that doesn't sound quite right. So think about the answer making sense as well. Example 5. A large plywood box has a volume of 180 cubic feet. Its length is 9 feet greater than its height, and its width is 4 feet less than its height. What are the dimensions of the box? So we want to answer what are the dimensions, but I only want one variable. So what variable am I going to do? Well, given that everything else is based on height, I'm going to let x be my height. So I've got some box here. Let me draw the box. Here's my little box with height x. Then its length, which I'm going to define as this front measurement here, is 9 feet greater than its height. So it's x plus 9. And its width is 4 feet less than its height, so it's x minus 4. You could have called it h if you like h for height. That's fine. It doesn't matter. Then we've expressed all the unknowns in terms of the variable. Now we have to set it up with the information we're given, which is that the volume is 180 cubic feet. So the volume is equal to the height times the width. Oh, sorry, that's length technically. Times the width is equal to 180. So now we need to multiply this out. So I've got x squared plus 9x times x minus 4. So I have x cubed minus 4x squared plus 9x squared minus 36x. And I'm going to go ahead and subtract that 180. So I have x cubed plus 5x squared minus 36x minus 180. Now, in order to just solve this, I have to find the zeros. I'm going to hope that this factors nicely in a way that might be a little counterintuitive to you, and it does. So I'm going to take these first two terms and take out the x squared, and I'm left with x plus 5. And then out of these next two terms, I'm going to take out, they have a negative 36 in common. And what I'm left with is x, and this turns into a plus. 180 divided by 36 is 5. So this happens to work out nicely. I'm not doing any kind of magic. I'm just grouping them by like terms and finding a factor that they have in common. So now I'll factor out x plus 5. I'm left with x squared minus 36, which is great because this is a difference of squares. So I have x plus 5 times x plus 6 times x minus 6. So what do I get? Out of this, I get that x could be negative 5, negative 6, or 6. Well, which of those makes any sense? This is the height of a box. So it can't be negative 5. It can't be negative 6. X must be equal to 6 in its feet. So that's the height. 6 feet. Then, so I have, it's a 6 foot by x plus 9 is 15 feet, and x minus 4 is by 2 feet box. So I've answered the question, what are the dimensions? I need to give all three to answer the question, and I've included units, and you can go back and check that the volume is indeed 180 cubic feet in order to check that. Okay, the last example we're going to do is one that trips up a lot of people, because there's a lot going on here. Kim drove from Tortola to Cactus, a distance of 250 miles. She increased her speed by 10 miles per hour for the 360-mile trip from Cactus to Dry Junction. If the total trip took 11 hours, what was her speed from Tortola to Cactus? And so, what do I need? What was her speed? That's what I need to know, right? So that's going to be my x. Her increased speed is x plus 10. Now, how do all these things relate? Well, how do I figure out how long it's going to take? I take my miles and I divide by how fast I'm going, and that'll give me the hours. How do I know that? Because I'm thinking about units. Miles divided by miles per hour is going to get me hours. So I need to do 250 divided by x plus 360 divided by x plus 10 is equal to 11 hours. Now, this is a linear equation that we've solved before. We can do any number of things. I'm going to get a common denominator, I think. So I'm going to take 250 times x plus 10 plus 360 times x all over x times x plus 10. Is equal to 11 times x plus 10. So we've done this before in a previous video, but if we get them all over the same fraction, then we know if these two fractions are equal, their tops, their numerators must be equal to zero, or equal to each other, sorry. So this is 250x plus 2500 plus 360x is equal to 11x squared plus 110x. So I'll get that all on one side. I'm going to move it to the right hand side so I have a positive x squared. 11x squared, I take 110 minus 360 minus 250, and I get negative 500x minus 2500. This is probably not something that most of us can factor right off the top of our head, and I know that's something that quite a few of you are going to struggle with anyway, factoring. So let's go ahead and put this in the quadratic formula and see what happens. So I'm going to set it all up. So pause just a second, set it up yourself, and check when you get done. Okay, so you can take a second to check that out. Negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. And I'm going to go ahead and do the arithmetic to get these all, what's under the square root and everything. So go ahead and pause and do that. So I went ahead and found the two solutions. The negative one doesn't make any sense. So the other one is 50 miles per hour, and that's going to be our final solution to her original speed was 50 miles per hour. Then she increased to 60 miles per hour after that.